Hello everyone and welcome to today's tutorial video. Today I'll be talking about Fibonacci 2. These two Fibonacci 2s, there are a lot of them and you can find them under this icon. That's where you find Fibonacci 2s. If you click on it, you see Fibonacci Retracement Trend Based Fibonacci Extension. These are the two I'll be talking about today. I'll talk about these two and their significance, their use today, and maybe if I see the need, I may talk about maybe Fib channel and maybe Fib time zone, and I may not talk about it. Any which way, let's just go for today's work, which is Fib retracement and Fib trend based Fib extension. I hope you enjoy it. Now let's start with Fib retracement. Fibonacci retracement. Now the major use of this Fibonacci retracement is to predict where price is going to turn around after after retracing from a long or strong impulsive move. For example, let's see, we have an impulsive move like this, something like this. Price went up that fast and it now begin to retrace. Now we all know that markets go in zigzag form, go up and down. Now, we're trying to get where this retracement will end. Where will it end? Where will it end? Is it here? Or is it here? Or is it here? Or is it here? So we can use this Fibonacci 2 to be able to predict where is high possible. Where the turnaround is high possible. Nobody knows for sure, but Fibonacci 2 can assist us to be able to predict where the turnaround is about may happen. Now all you have to do is pick on the two, pick on the Fib retracement, then bring your crochet, bring the point to the beginning of the impulsive move and drag it to where the retracement began. You can see some lines with numbers. You can see we have 0.236, 0.382, 0.5, 0.61, and 0.786. Now these are the possible level that we're expecting in what a reversal. Now if the impulse is very very strong, if the uptrend is very very strong, then there's high probability that we may be retracing here these first two lines. If it is a very strong impulsive move, we can see something like this, or see something like this, or that's it if it is very impulsive. But immediately it refused to reverse in any of those lines, then the next one will be the 50%, that's 0.5, or 61%, that's 0.61. So we'll be expecting it to do something like this. Do you understand? Now this is it, the most popular one is this 0.61. we'll call it what, golden ratio. Most of the time price will bounce in between that this line. This 0.61, it is the golden ratio. That's where you expect the bounce, but sometimes it may not get there before it bounce. Now, this is the psychology behind it. Now, those that bought at this point, for one reason or the other, they began to sell. That's why you see the price going down. Now, we are trying to know when new buyers will come in, because when people begin to sell, that's when price go down. So immediately, new buyers step in, then begin to go up again. Now we'll be looking at where new buyers will probably come in. Now, if something was 1500 naira a while ago, and all of a sudden you see it at 15 naira, you want to buy because it's now cheaper, right? Now, it was at look at it here. It was at 0.780, reading from here, 0.78000. Then it rose to 0.88000. Now, if you should come back to middle of at least half of that price, it is going to be a fair price to buy in. And some people may want it to go below. Most people wait for this golden ratio, which is what? 618. So those are the two ratio we'll be looking at. Personally, that's the two lines me I use. I don't normally use I use this 382 if I have other confluences, strong confluences. But the one I use majorly is 618 and 0.5. I don't really like using this because when price start approaching this 786, it shows that buyers are not stepping in. And there's probability that it will just go down to where it started the move. I hope that is clear. So now let's look for then for sale also. You just have to go the other way. If you are doing for sale, you delete. Let's see, for sale now we have something like this. Right, no. Price was going down impulsively, then it turned around. So we want to know where it will get to, probably get to before it continues downward movement. Now all you have to do is carry your FIB retracement tool, put it at the beginning of the impulsive move, and track it down. So we'll be expecting some reaction at 0.5 or 0.61 FIB level. That's where our attention will be. Then if you have strong confluence, then you can also watch 0.382. That is how to use it. Now let's go to the chart and find some example. Just look at the move we have here. As you can see, price was going down impulsively going down. So it started retracing. Now we want to know when sellers are possible to come in again, since we are selling this time around. So we'll just put our FIB here at the beginning of the trend, then we'll drag it down. Can you see? Did you see what just happened there? We have some new buyers in between the 0.61 line and 0.5. Can you see it? In between the 0.618 and the 0.5. So that would be a good point to buy. But you cannot sell because of this alone. It's not advisable to trade based off one factor. You want to find confluence, all that stuff I've spoken about, like support and resistance, like trend lines. You shall want to look for something else. Let's say you draw your trend line from here like this, and now something like this. I did not quite hit it. You can decide to take your trend line from the close. It's also allowed. Let's see if that will hit it. From the close. This is the connect, but it's close to it. It's close to it. As you can see, it's very close to it. Then you can just look for other confluences. That's just my point. That's it for the sell. Let's look for one example for buy. Okay, this is a very nice example here. This is the beginning of this move, of this particular impulsive move. So we can check. Then there's a major retracement here. So we can see where this, look for where this retracement will end. But we're already seeing this, but let's assume we are not seeing this part of the chart. We have something like this. See, do you understand? We have something like this. Now we want to know, we just see it going down. We want to know where it will probably turn around. You carry your fib, put it at the low of it here. Then you drag it up. So let's see. No, this is not what I want to do. Let's see. Can you see? The reversal happened exactly on the 0.618 line and it went up. So that is all for Fibonacci retracements. I'll do another video for the second one, which is Fibonacci trend based Fibonacci extension. Thanks for watching.